This is the one who was not deserted by God on the day of struggle, and now bears a crown of victory for faithfulness to the Lord's commands. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today is the feast of St. John Houghton, Carthusian, and one of the proto-martyrs of the English Reformation. And we ask for his prayers today, and offer this Mass for the soul of Mike Foley, our brother James's brother, whose funeral takes place today. So we commend his soul to God and pray for his family, especially this Holy Mass. Let us first call to mind our sins and ask God for mercy upon us. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Hear me.
Strong hold to save me.
For you are my rock, my stronghold. For your name's sake, lead me and guide me.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit. It is you who will redeem me, Lord. As for me, I trust in the Lord. Let me be glad and rejoice in your love.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Let your face shine on your servant. Save me in your love. You hide them in the shelter of your presence, from the plotting of men.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Alleluia.
Perhaps the Carthusian order have always done social distancing, they're rather the strictest order in the church and have always lived a life of great seclusion. And the funny thing about John Houghton and his companions was that although they were in a strict monastic life, they were well known. Why was that? Well, they had a school. They were known for spiritual direction. And they were extremely learned. They were respected. So even though they lived a hidden life, people knew who they were and knew that they could count on the prayers of these holy men. Perhaps the world outside today knows who we are, and all of us, Catholics, clerical and lay, the world needs to know that it can count on our prayers in odd times. It also needs to know that it can count on our witness when it really counts. John Houghton is famous too for having said at his death, as they tore his heart from his body, "O Jesus, what wilt thou do with my heart?" It's extraordinary witness, as if the executioner had opened an oven door by cutting open John's body, because there was such love in him. And his final words were simply to Jesus, "Jesu, Jesu, est mihi, Jesus, be unto me a Jesus," in other words, "be unto me a Saviour." This is what the martyrs are still known for. We pray that we too might be heroic in our faith. Perhaps our life and our blood may not be ours of us, but we pray that we will have the same heroism that they had, and the same warmth in our heart that called out to the heart of our Blessed Lord when it really counted. Finally, there's one thing that we sometimes think about this period, looking back at it, as I say, 485 years ago, a long time. When we think about the cruel death of the martyrs in this period, their great heroism certainly, but also the horrible ways in which they died, and we're tempted to think of it as a very primitive age, a long way from our own. But 1535 was the height of the English Renaissance. It was the age of discovery, of medicine, of advances in astronomy, of the discovery of the new world, great learning and letters. It was the age of a flourishing of universities for the common man. This was not a backwards time. And we might be tempted to think that we live in a very advanced time. And yet there are martyrs whose blood is required every day, even now. So let us pray very earnestly that the prayer of our martyrs, especially our noble ones, will sanctify our land, sanctify our society, and their prayers protect us, who in these odd times must have heroic faith and stand up in Christ. St. John Houghton, pray for us.
Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, accept this offering of praise in memory of your martyr John Houghton, and may it bring us your forgiveness and inspire us to give you thanks, now and forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr John, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvellous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness, through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without him, we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis in celi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna.
In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out.
The ministry of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the elevation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. cast an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with our holy fathers Augustine and Norbert, with St. John Houghton and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing will. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation be prayed, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confer in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Alan our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have gained your will. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Mike, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good.
Through and with and in, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours, forever.
ex glorie, mortis surrexit podie. Alleluia. 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 Emane prima sabbati, ad ostiom omnum enti, ad esse lunt discipuli. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits, who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
For the sacred heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
For the sacred heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
For the sacred heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.